This is Halloween.
In this town, we call home. Everyone hail to the pumpkin song.
In this town. This is here. Do Fredbear's Fright, so yeah. Dead game, so we can play it. So let's do it. Yes. How about it, Fredbear's Fright? Fun fact, I can barely read that so blurry. But we don't need to read it, we just need to play the game, that's it. Night 1. Alright, back there tonight.
Hello and welcome to your new job at the spooky, haunty place where animatronics swarm around the Shovian suits, etc. Just kidding, those things are wired up and can't move around, like how they were fabled to back in the day. In fact, you're sitting in the original Freddy Fazbear's Pizza right now. Is that neat? The owners of this location sold the property to Fun Frights Incorporated while they're looking for a place to build their new attractions. So what a coincidence that the old pizza place was here. How perfect for an old creepy restaurant to be in this exact area. The land was very cheap too. I mean, the building was so messed up that they had to either destroy it or attempt to renovate it. Of course, they were going bankrupt, so they decided to try selling it, leading to where you currently are. Speaking of the building being in poor condition, we've had to work in renovating parts of it already. Almost everything is complete, but the power died shortly after we started renovating. We have resorted to using a generator, so make sure you don't run out of generator energy. If you do, just try to find a flashlight or something. It's looking pretty spooky in there, so good luck with that. Oh man. Oh yeah. I guess I have to read the safety packet to you. Alright. Welcome to Fredbear's Fright, the latest and greatest horror attraction featuring actual relics from the original diners, where mysteries about the events were tragic but not certain. In case of any sort of injury or harm inflicted by an animatronic occurs, we are not to be held responsible, as it is your own fault doing so. If the chance of a person has turned up missing or has a fatal event happened within our premises, the location of that event will be cleaned up after the attraction's running hours, blah blah blah. What a bunch of nonsense. I mean, I could understand injuries if someone was just plain old dumb with our equipment, but to die in our building, that's ridiculous. Our animatronics should be just fine. Anyways, let's finish up on how you have to work the place. So to your left, you have a big old door thing from the old Freddy Fazbear's Pizzeria. It's used to close off guests while they're playing the flashlight game next to your office. It makes a cool transition from when they leave the game and enter the office. And finally, to your right, you have a false vent that you can shut once the guests have exited. We don't want them coming back through, or something like that? I don't know. Alright, I'll leave you to it now. See you on the flip side.
Oh, I didn't see that, so... Alright, first of all, what is that? What is that? I was wondering, what is that? Oh, there he is. Okay. I guess it's just these two.
Hello? Oh, hey. Welcome back to Fredbear's Fright. I'm hoping that you're starting to get comfortable now. Okay, so I have some pretty good news right now. We have been working on the animatronic programming and they seem to be working a bit now. That prototype animatronic endoskeleton is starting to be able to turn around and stuff now, along with a few others having some movement now. I think that's pretty cool. Do you think so? Okay. Time for a bit more info on things you can operate in your office. So, do you see that pullable lever on the office's ceiling? You can use that to fill up your spray bottle in the morning when you have to go clean up the animatronics. Make sure to only clean the joints, as getting liquids on the animatronic parts themselves could damage the electronics inside, or even mess up the coating. I know it's silly to have that lever right there instead of a sink, but I guess that doesn't really matter. Okay, you have a camera system to look at on your laptop, which also is a half-restored thing from Freddy Fazbear's. You can check the rooms as people go through the attraction, and make sure that no one goes into the attic or somewhere they shouldn't be. Also keep an eye on prototype. It seems to move a bit at random times, so just look at it from time to time to make sure it doesn't fall over. Then there's an animatronic moveset operator to the right of your office, which is still a work in progress. That should eventually make an animatronic do something spooky when you enter a certain code. All this stuff should be complete in nearly a week. So if something doesn't work correctly, or you see some boxes laying around, those things will be worked on. Programming the animatronics and working on the building functions will be our top priority over the next couple of days. Alright, I'll be getting some shut eye. Good night.
The puppets are gone. It's okay, for, I was looking all over for a friend. I couldn't see him. Thank you. assume you're working for... Oh, I see the fit. Alright, so he can't fit in the van. It's just Fredbear and puppets. Need to focus on looking at the cameras. What I need to do is just focus on for a tank. Yeah, that's really good to know. So I just see the again. I'm not gonna focus on the time as much, and that was quite a bit. I don't think it was just a door. So use that Fredbear. Then, it said, so either it's... Thank you. heard someone in the vent. I click close the door and risk it. There you go. Entering 93, but in the let's see whoever can kill me first. So subscribe to the great subscribe if you're new to the channel. Leave a like, prepare your videos to share your video, please, discussion, secretary, and on my channel. And hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future videos. I'll be also joined by the subscribe. Hope you guys are here. Until next time, bye.
Spooky, scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your soul.